Welcome, everybody. We have Dhruv here with us today, and he's a product engineer at Udacity. So Dhruv, tell us the story about how you learned your first framework.
The first framework I used was in college. It was Ruby on Rails. And people will usually teach you frameworks as a starting point into building your first application because it takes away a lot of the decisions and complexities for you. So you can just jump into a framework, learn it, and ideally get building your first application in a couple days. So that was the first general framework I used. The first front-end specific framework I used was Angular. I used it in a summer internship in my senior year. And again, it was like, at the time I saw it, it was like nothing I'd ever seen, but it helped me get moving quickly into routing, building views, and generally getting the fundamental design patterns of the web quickly.
So now that you're working with one framework, how difficult was it to switch to a new framework?
The truth is a lot of these frameworks come from radically different paradigms. So Angular and React are almost have very different philosophies about things. But a lot of them do share commonalities. So for instance, if you go between Angular and Ember, both are generally MVC frameworks. And if you know one, you get the guiding principles or the ideas behind the others. A framework like React comes at it from a very different way. But knowing another framework helps you evaluate another framework you're using. So knowing Angular helped me understand a lot more about why React is useful, what were the guiding philosophies that made it unique and appealing to developers, and understanding the trade-offs that came with it compared to a system like Angular or Ember.
Okay. So if you are learning frameworks, you shouldn't just find your first one and stick with that for life. You should experience the other ones, build something with them, see what are the needs of your application, and then pick the best framework for that.
Definitely. I think that's a very good answer. There are some frameworks that are fairly impractical, but I learned them anyways because they, again, teach you philosophies and ideas of approaching programming that are unique. So in particular, I checked out Elmlang, which is a very functional approach to doing front-end programming. I've looked at ClojureScript a lot, again, another very functional perspective to doing programming. And these have all affected how I view the frameworks I use today. And in addition to just looking at what works for you at this given point in time, it's also worth looking at what the general community is working towards. Because if you work with the community, you're going to get a lot of tools, a lot of resources that you wouldn't get otherwise if you choose a very niche framework. So there's a lot of considerations to make, but understanding that not all frameworks are perfect and that every framework might not be perfect for the job you're choosing is a very good place to start.
So what is some advice that you would give to students that are looking to dive into the world of frameworks?
To start by not looking at the fine-grained details of how to implement X, Y, or Z in a framework, although you'll have to do that in your app, but at some point to take a step back and try and figure out what's the philosophy of this framework. A framework is essentially some really smart people somewhere have designed this intricate system to help you accomplish something. There's a lot to learn in just looking at how it was designed, and you can reuse a lot of those concepts in future things you build. So the first thing is just looking at the framework, understanding it, and understanding how it was created, what the decisions were. I mean, frameworks are always going to be good at some things and bad at some things. Understanding those trade-offs and learning to appreciate those.